Hello everyone. As we already discussed in the previous videos about profit and loss, what is profit, what is loss, what is profit percent, loss percent, the selling price and the cost price. Now, we are saying that when we talk about profit and loss, it can be in two ways. First, it can be in the context of price. Like if we purchase an article for rupees 100 and sells it for rupees 120, there is a profit of rupees 20. Or if I purchase the article for rupees 50 and sells it for rupees 40, then there is a loss of rupees 10. Here we are discussing about another aspect of profit and loss, where instead of price, there is a change in the number of articles or commodity. When I am saying the number of articles or commodity, that means we are discussing about this and this as a questions. The first is toffees are bought at a rate of 7 for rupee 1 and sold at a rate of 5 for rupee 1. Here the number of toffees are 7, here the number of toffees are 5, and the cost is given as the same. The cost price is 1 and selling price is also 1. Or in this question, we are saying the cost price of 10 article is equal to the selling price of 8 article. Then definitely if we purchase 10 article at a particular price and sells 8 out of them on the same price, it means we are saving 2 articles or we are left with 2 articles. So there also we have to calculate the profit percent, and because we cannot calculate profit percent in the number of articles, then also we have to see that how to solve this kind of question. Now, a very very important thing is, if I am saying that if I purchase 1 article for rupees 40 and sells the same article for rupees 50, then what is the profit percent? Here it is 10 rupees as a profit out of 40. When you multiply it by 100, it comes out to be 25%. Same way, instead of 1 article, if I am saying that I have purchased 2 article at the same cost, so 40 rupees 1 article, so 2 article must be for rupees 80. And I am selling at the same cost, that instead of 50, 2 article is selling at rupees 100. So here also there is a profit of rupees 20 from 80 to 100. But this profit is out of 80 multiplied by 100, again we get 25%. Instead of 1 or 2 article, suppose I am talking about 10 number of articles. If I purchase 10 articles at the same cost, then the cost price will be 400. And the selling price will be 500. Here also there is a profit of 100 rupees, but this 100 rupees profit is out of 400, the cost price. If we solve it, it again comes out to be 25%. This shows that whatever the number of articles are, it does not matter. The only thing is, if I am purchasing one article and selling one article, I can calculate the profit percent or the loss percent. If I am purchasing 5 articles and selling 5 articles, I can find out the profit or loss percent. If I am purchasing and selling 10 articles, then also I can calculate the profit percent. But it is not possible to calculate the profit percent when I am purchasing 7 toffees and selling 5 toffees out of them for the same cost. Now, this question can be treated in 2 different ways. So this question can be also written in this way. Now, how to answer this question? In our books, it is generally given that first of all, we have to find out the cost price of one toffee and the selling price of one toffee, and then to calculate the profit percent or the loss percent. When I am saying it is 7, this is the number of articles or the toffees, this is for rupee 1 and this is the cost price. When I am saying 5, the number of articles, it is 4 rupee 1 again and this is the selling price. This can be treated as the cost price of 7 articles. Like here, the cost price of 10 articles. So here we can say the cost price of 7 articles is equal to the selling price of 5 articles. Or I am saying the 7 toffees I am buying for rupee 1 and 5 toffees I am buying selling for rupees 1. So what is the profit percent? Here I told you already that whenever the number of articles is same, then only we can find out the profit or the loss percent. Now if I want to equate these two numbers, if I multiply this by 5 and this by 7. It means we have equated the number of articles. Here it is 7 multiplied by 5, here it is 5 multiplied by 7. If we see the first equation, I am seeing 35 toffees. For 35 toffees, when we multiply it by 5, it is for rupees 5. So we can say the cost price of 35 toffees is rupees 5. And selling price of 35 toffees. Now we have equated the number of articles. So the selling price of 35 toffees, when you multiply it by 7, comes out to be rupees 7. This is the selling price. Now I have converted this question in a question, simple question, that 35 toffees I am buying for rupees 5 and 35 toffees I am selling for rupees 7. Now we can directly find out the profit percent. And here 2 rupees is the profit, because after rupees 5 on, I am selling for rupees 7, that is on rupees 5 multiplied by 100, it comes out to be 40%. So this way we can calculate the profit percent in this question. When I look at this question, then also it is very simple. Here the number of articles are 7 and 5. Actually what we are doing is, we are equating the number of articles, and this number of articles we can equate by taking the LCM of two numbers 5 and 7, which is actually 35 in this case. Why in this case? I can write it in the same way, in this way, or I can write this question in this way. Here I can say 10 articles. The cost price of 10 articles, whatever it is, I can assume it as rupee 1. And the selling price of 8 articles is the same, so I can also assume rupee 1 as the selling price of 8 articles. So I am saying the cost price of 10 articles is rupee 1 and the selling price of 8 articles is rupee 1. Again, taking the LCM of 10 and 8, it comes out to be 40. Or I can directly multiply this by 8 and multiply by this by 10 to make it equal. If I am saying the LCM is 40, so we can say these can be equated for number 40 as well. Or multiplying this number by 4 and this number by 5, we can equate these two numbers. It is 4 10 ja 40, it is 5 8 ja 40. When I am multiplying the first equation by 4, it is 40 articles for rupees 4. This is the cost price. In the second equation, 40 articles for rupees 5, this is the selling price. Now, because the number of articles is same as we have discussed in this, now we can directly calculate the profit percent. It comes out to be 1, rupees is the profit, out of 4, which is the cost price, into 100, and this shows it is 25%. Now, we have changed this question into this format. Same way we can change this question into this format as well. So these two questions looks like to be different, but they are same. Actually what we are doing in both the questions is, we are equating the number of articles. Definitely when 10 articles and 8 articles are there, we cannot equate for 17 articles, because 10 has to be multiplied by 1.7 and this has to be multiplied by some other number. These can be equated if we take the LCM, or directly by multiplying this by this and this by this. If I multiply the first equation by 8 and multiply the second equation by 10, then the number of articles comes out to be 80, which is same. You can put it like this: 10 articles for rupee 1, 8 articles for rupee 1. If I multiply it by 8, then the cost price comes out to be 8 rupee. If I multiply it by 10, the cost selling price comes out to be rupee 10, and directly we can find out the profit, that is 2 out of 8 multiplied by 100, which comes out to be 25%. So overall I am saying that if the question of profit and loss is in the context of commodities or the article, it is better to equate the number of articles, whatever the number of articles are there, and then to see the cost price and selling price and then solve it. Thank you.